Hi everyone, and welcome to another Placeit tutorial. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to create t-shirt designs like the ones that you see here. There's over 8,000 different templates to choose from. Then I'm going to show you this somewhat secret second way to create t-shirt designs on Placeit. Then lastly, I'll show you how to take those designs that we've just created and put them onto thousands of different mockup templates. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get started. Alright, so first things first in this tutorial, we need to go to the Placeit homepage. Now, if you're not familiar with Placeit, it's one of the biggest graphic design tools out there, and it's one of the fastest growing as well. However, it is a premium service, so you do have to pay monthly to get access to it. With that being said though, I do have a Placeit referral link that I'll put down in the description. The benefit to using that is it gives anyone who signs up with it a 15% off discount. So if you do watch this whole tutorial through and you decide you want to sign up, feel free to use that link and it'll give you 15% off. So let's go ahead and get started by making a t-shirt design. So once you come to the homepage, we're just going to hover over designs and go to t-shirt designs. And this is going to be the standard way of creating a t-shirt design here on Placeit. Now they have literally hundreds of different pages of templates for you to choose from. So you can scroll through here and hover over these to see some variations of how you could customize this template. Or you can come to the left side and you can sort it by category if you're looking for something specific. So let's go ahead and pick one of these to edit for this tutorial, and I'll pick the first one up top here. So once you pick one of these templates, it's going to bring you into the Placeit editor. Now over on the left side is going to be your text and font, and over on the right side is going to be graphics and colors. Now starting with the left side over here, each one of these text boxes is going to correspond to a text area that's on the template. Now you can take any of these text areas, you can make them bigger, smaller, you can move them around. And then if you decide you want to go back to the original layout, at any point when you're editing through here, you can just click Reset Layout, and it will bring all of the elements and sizing back to where they were when the template started. So to edit this text, all you do is highlight the text over here and change it to anything you want it to say. You can change the font by clicking this dropdown and choosing from any of these fonts here. Now there are a ton of fonts to choose from. You will see that this varies slightly from template to template. However, you can always click more fonts and get access to their full catalog of fonts. If there's something specific you're looking for, feel free to just search it up here in the corner. Now, one more thing you can do with the fonts is instead of just changing the font type, you can change the font color by hitting this color dropdown here. You can choose from any of these default colors, or again, you can hit more. You can change the sliders to find something specific, or if you have a specific color hex code that you'd like to use, you can enter that right here. Now, two more things with font. First is you can hit the eye icon at any point to hide a certain one of these text areas. When you hit this, it's going to rework the design without that text area in it. And then the last thing with text and font over here is you can add another line of text. When you do click and add this, it's going to set it kind of to defaults. So make sure that you change the font over here. And then also, as you can see, it has this background to it. So if you want to take that away, just hit the color dropdown, go to text background, and change it to the checkerboard, which will be transparent. Now remember with this one as well, you can move this anywhere on the template. You can make it bigger or smaller. And then if you don't want it anymore, you can either just move it to the side outside of your canvas, or you can hit the eye icon to turn it off. Now something that you'll see below the text area is upload a logo. You can click this and it'll allow you to upload an image from your computer. So if you have a logo that you want to include on this design for your branding, or if you just have an image file from your computer, you can upload that by clicking this button. Next up, coming over to the right side, we have colors and we have graphics. So you will see, depending on which template you are editing and what kind of features they have in that template, you'll have different options. So starting off at the top of this template, we have circle color, which corresponds to the circle that's in the background over here. Now, as a quick reminder to get that back where we like it, we just hit Reset Layout. It goes right back to where it should be. But needless to say, we can change the color of this circle by clicking anywhere on these defaults or the more colors here. Next up is probably the most important part of creating a t-shirt design. This background color, we need to make sure that we set it to transparent. So set it to that checkerboard. This will take the background color out of this template, meaning that we can put it on any t-shirt color. And when it gets printed, it's only going to print our t-shirt design and not actually this rectangle of color that's in the background. This is extremely important, so make sure that you don't miss this step. Next up, we have the option to add another graphic. This is going to be just like the upload logo button that's over here, except it's going to add a graphic and also give us access to their library of graphics to choose from. So right now it just added this graphic right here. We can change that graphic to anything in their library. We can even search for other topics and it'll sort their library. Or just like the upload logo button that we had over here, you can upload an image from your computer. Now again, if you don't want this in your design anymore, you can drag it off to the side, or you can hit no image. Now the last thing for creating this t-shirt design is this main graphic in the middle here. Now this is the best part of using Placeit, because just like the library that came up down here, we have relevant images from their library that already relate and fit perfectly into this design template. So you can simply click any of these different graphics, it'll change them in real time in your design, or you can search for something completely different and sub in those graphics into this design as well. Now the second most important thing when creating t-shirt designs comes to copyright, trademark, and licensing. This is something that most people overlook. However, in very simple terms, anything that you find here on Placeit and all of the designs, anything that you download from Placeit is fully commercially usable. This means that if you're going to sell that on t-shirts with print on demand or use it for any business use where you're going to profit from it, it is 100% okay. This is one of the biggest benefits to using Placeit because they have the biggest library of commercially usable graphics and designs. So all we've got to do at this point is just go ahead and click download. And just like anything on Placeit, it'll have this drop down that says processing your design. Give that a second to load and then it'll change to click here to download. All right, just like that, this design is ready to go. We'll download it directly to our computer. And this design is now ready to go on a t-shirt. As you can see, when you zoom into these designs, they are in high quality, so it will print on t-shirts without being blurry. And it has a transparent background, so it can print on any color shirt. All right, so that is the standard way of creating t-shirt designs here on Placeit. Now I want to show you the second way that not many people know about. So from any page on Placeit, just hover over logos and go to Logo Maker. Now instead of entering anything here, just go to See All of Our Templates. And this will give you thousands more templates to choose from. Now these templates are typically used for creating logos for a business, and since some of these are really advanced templates with really advanced graphics, these actually used to be only available to buy them on an individual basis for $40 per download. Now Placeit has included them with any of the plans, so you pay about $15 per month and you can download unlimited of these and put them on t-shirts to sell. For anyone who has been in the t-shirt space or print-on-demand space for a long time, you likely understand how big of a deal this is that you can download unlimited of these for only that $15 per month. So with that said, let's edit one of these and I'll show you how it works. So you'll notice that the layout looks very similar from the t-shirt designs we were creating before. There's just a couple more buttons here and there, and they're just going to be different ways to customize this template. Now the biggest thing that you're going to notice in these templates as opposed to the other templates we were just creating is these graphics are way more detailed. This is really good for creating t-shirt designs because previously, if you wanted to create a design that was something like the graphics you find here, you really needed to have a lot of graphic design experience, and it takes a long time to create these by hand. Now, something else that I really like about this is the text and the graphic are not just separated from each other, but they actually physically overlap depending on which graphics and which combination of text you're putting in here. So it takes your t-shirt designing to another level and gives you a unique aspect that buyers will be really drawn to. So I think we're probably all on the same page on how to use all of these features here. I'm just going to make sure that we change our background to transparent before we download this. And then, just like before, we click download up top. And just like that, this one's now going to be downloaded on our computer as well. All right, just like that, we now have two t-shirt designs made in a couple of minutes here. Now I'll show you how to put these onto mockups. So let's come back to Placeit. And again, from any page here, you can hover over mockups, go to Mockup Generator. And this is going to bring you to all of their mockups here on Placeit. Now, as you can see, some of these are t-shirts, some of them are mugs, some of them are face masks. You have all different categories that you'll find in their mockups. The mockups feature is what originally made Placeit famous way back when the site was just starting out. So you're going to find the most templates here and also the most wow factor from their graphic design tool. The technology that they have for making these mockups is pretty impressive. So since we're looking for a t-shirt mockup, I'm just going to take out all of the other things that are not t-shirts by coming to the left side here, scrolling down, and finding t-shirts only. Now, as you can see here, there's over 10,000 different mockups specifically for t-shirts, so you will never have a shortage of mockup templates to choose from. So feel free to pick any of these. I'm just going to pick this one right here, and this is the one we'll put our design on. So the cool thing with mockups here on Placeit is they are extremely easy to use. You only have a few options here. If you want to add text to this design, you just have to click add text. Again, it's going to bring in the same thing we had before. Remember to take that background out, just hit text background, switch it to transparent, and now you can have any text you want on your mockup. Now on this mockup, I'm not going to have any text, so I'm just going to hide that. And then the next option here is to insert your image. Once you click that, it's going to bring up two options, either upload from your device. This will allow you to upload the t-shirt designs that we just downloaded to our computer. Or the other option is import from downloads. This is going to be more helpful if you want to use a t-shirt design that you created a long time ago on Placeit and you don't exactly know where it is on your computer. It'll allow you to choose from the previous designs that you have downloaded from Placeit in the past. Now, since we just downloaded our t-shirt designs to our computer, I'm going to click upload from your device. All right, once you select your t-shirt design, it'll bring you into this cropping area. Now, this is actually pretty important. For a t-shirt design, we don't want it to be in the stomach. We want this to be kind of in the chest area of the t-shirt. Now, you can zoom this in if you want to make this fill the area a little bit more and put it right up in the chest area. Once it looks pretty good, you can just hit crop, and then it'll show you a preview of what that looks like on the shirt. Now, if you find out that it's too low or too high or too big, you just come back to resize and you can edit this again. Now there's only one more step that you really need to know for mockups, and that is the shirt color. So if you have white text or something like that and it's on a white shirt, or if you just generally want to change the color of the shirt, you can just open this up, change the color, and in real time it'll change that color of the shirt that the model is wearing. Now from using Placeit for a long time, a feature that not many people know is here is there's actually an undo button or a back button that you can do for this editor. Since you can't find it anywhere on the screen here in Placeit, you actually have to click the back button on your internet browser. This will act simply as an undo button when you're editing things, so keep that in mind if you want to undo any changes. Now the last option you have for editing mockups is to add a graphic. And just like we talked about before, it's going to add a graphic to your template. You can choose from the library, you can upload your own, or you can hit no image to make it go away. The last step is to click download. Now we'll just save that to the computer. And just in the matter of a few minutes, we have created a standard t-shirt design, we've created a more advanced t-shirt design, and then we've taken a t-shirt design and put it onto a mockup. Now, just as a reminder, the 15% off link is down in the description, so if you are interested at this point to make a Placeit account and start making these designs for yourself and making mockup photos, then hopefully that discount helps. Alright guys, that's it for this video. Hopefully this has been helpful. If you have any questions about Placeit, just let me know. Otherwise, I will see you all in the next Placeit tutorial.